The natural sciences and Charles Darwin in particular have proposed answers. To such science, human beings are creatures, animals, linked biologically with the rest of evolving matter energy systems in the physical universe. Such science demonstrates that human existence is not simply given. Rather, it is something to be worked through the process of adaptation to the environment and evolution. One of the social sciences applying to the dominant 20% of the world's cultures, the Western world, psychology, concerns itself with the interactions of human beings and the effects of these interactions. But whereas the natural sciences focus on the interaction of human behavior and the environment outside the human person, psychology concerns itself with the interaction of Western human behavior and the world inside the Western person, the person affected directly by the Industrial Revolution. The introspective individualist. Sigmund Freud gave us the special contribution and has been improved on ever since. Human existence is not simply an affair of knowing what to do, intellect, and then deciding to do it, will, the way the old Catholic moral manuals had it. You know what the commandments are, you didn't do it, mortal sin, right? No, no, humans are a psychological abyss. Abyss. At least Western humans. Psychology reveals that there are unconscious drives, forces, and motives that influence and to some extent may even determine our choices and behavior. Huh? Other social sciences are concerned with the social, economic, and political context in which human persons find themselves. These are the realms of sociology and economics. Here, the world has been shaped by the thought of Karl Marx and his social analysis. As with Freud, Marx insisted that human problems can be traced back to conflicts produced by alienation. But whereas for Freud, the alienation comes from being alienated from your true self, for Karl Marx, the origin of human alienation derives from the fruits of one's labors, and thus from the industrialized world and from other Western people. I mean, all people. Westerners tend to be ethnocentric. They tend to think all peoples are Western peoples. For Karl Marx, society is the only way in which and through which persons can live as human beings. You see, these are also, you understand what I'm doing for you here. These are answers proposed to the question of human existence that the church has to deal with. Oh, I don't need this. I just need my rosary. I can pray my rosary. I don't need this. What is your rosary then? If it's not rooted to human existence and the question of human existence, I ask. Everything we do as church has to be rooted in the context of who are we as human beings. Otherwise, we are irrelevant. Like so many young people think we are. For Marx, we are defined as who and what we are only by the collective. Feminist thought is another way of addressing who we are. It presents a wide-ranging interdisciplinary critique of the ethos and practice of sexism and gender discrimination, as expressed in patriarchal society, political systems, and religious structures, and in androcentric thought and language. Just ignore it? Don't we have to address it too? Philosophy of the 1800s and 1900s covers a wider berth of approaches. Phenomenology, existentialism, process theology, pragmatic philosophy, the philosophies of positivism and ordinary language. In much of these philosophies, there is an emphasis on the subjective, the changeable, the particular, and the practical. This is over against the classical Western metaphysical tradition of Plato, Aristotle, St. Augustine, and St. Thomas Aquinas, which emphasized the objective, the unchanging, the universal, and the abstract. Human existence has been discovered by human beings living in these postmodern times to be something that is not static and not a given to be examined, but a potential in the process of realization, actualization, a dynamic reality, evolving, changing, growing, becoming more aware. Right? Not static, like ancients saw things. How does the church address the question of what it means to be human?